Grumpy Kid Volume 10, Journal d'un Dagonflie, it was kind of an exciting book for me to write because Greg is such a child of technology. I take technology away from Greg and his family and from his whole universe. And it's interesting to kind of go back in time with Greg to before the internet and before, you know, screens were everywhere. So Greg goes to a school that's out in the woods where kids have to learn to survive without technology. They have to learn to do hard work. And I thought it was a lot of fun to write. I like the title here in France, Zéro Réseau. That's really good. In the US, it's called Old School, which means two things. Old school is kind of like classic, which is kind of cool, but old school also means literally old school. So it's where Greg goes is an old school. I think it's really interesting. I think especially in the past 10 years, technology has really changed us. It's changed the way kids behave with one another, and it's changed the way people communicate with one another. It's not uncommon to see a whole family out to dinner and everybody's on a screen. And I think it's actually a problem. I know that's not fun or funny, but it really is a problem because people aren't communicating the way that they used to, one-to-one. Greg came from my failing to become a newspaper cartoonist. I really wanted to be a newspaper cartoonist like Charles Schulz or Bill Watterson, but I couldn't break into that industry. So I started drawing as a kid, and I pretended I was a kid with Diary of a Wimpy Kid. And so I wrote in a journal format, and I worked on it for about 8 years. And finally, when I was done, I was ready to show it to people. But I wrote one draft that was 1,300 pages long before I was ready to show it to anyone. I think the reason that kids like Greg Heffler, they like the Diary of Wimpy Kid stories, is because they can see themselves in Greg and his family members and Greg's friends. I think that my stories are really about an ordinary childhood. It's not about a fantastical childhood, just an ordinary childhood. And that's what I had. And most kids around the world are growing up in an ordinary sort of way. They have parents and teachers and pets and siblings and enemies, you know, and I just wanted to write about the real world. I think I got really lucky with my books because I actually wrote them for adults. When I was writing Diary of a Wimpy Kid, I was trying to write stories that adults might like to read about looking back on childhood. And because of that, because I was writing for adults, when my publisher decided to turn it into a children's series, I found out that, you know, I wasn't writing down to kids. If I thought I was writing for kids, I would have written the books a little bit differently. I would have tried to teach kids a lesson. And I think that kids read to be entertained. They don't always want a lesson. I've just written my 11th book, and now I'm working on my 12th book. So my 11th book comes out next year in France. In America, it's called Double Down, which is kind of, it means that I'm sort of betting on this. I'm putting all of my money in the center of the table and saying I'm betting on this. I'm excited about the future of the Diary of a Wimpy Kid books because I think there are a lot more stories to tell, and it'll be a challenge to keep it fresh, but I'm up for that challenge.